I bring greetings to you in the precious name of Jesus, our soon coming King, Lord, and Savior. We are going to be making some prophetic decrees, declarations, and confessions. No weapon formed against us shall prosper. Every tongue that rises up against us in judgment, we condemn. We are established in righteousness, and oppression is far from us. The weapon of our warfare are not carnal, but they are mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. We take the shield of faith, and we quench every fiery dart of the enemy. We take the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of the Lord, and we use it to overcome the enemy, since he's already a defeated foe. We are redeemed from the curse of the law. We are redeemed from poverty. We are redeemed from every sickness. We are redeemed from spiritual death. We overcome all, because greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. We stand in the evil day, having our loin girt about with truth, wearing the breastplate of righteousness, our feet shod with the gospel of peace. We take the shield of faith. We are covered with the helmet of salvation, and we use the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. We are delivered from the power of darkness and translated into the kingdom of God's dear Son. We tread upon serpents, scorpions, and all the powers of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt us. We do not have the spirit of fear, but power, love, a sound, disciplined mind. We are blessed with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. We are healed with the stripes of Jesus Christ. Our hand is upon the neck of our enemies. You anoint our head with oil. Our cup runs over. Goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life. We are anointed to preach, teach, heal, and cast out devils. We receive abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness, and will reign in life through Jesus Christ. We have life, and that more abundantly. We walk in the light as he is in the light, and the blood of Jesus Christ cleanses us from every sin. We are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. We are the head and not the tail. We shall decree a thing, and it shall be established in our lives. We have favor with God and with man. Wealth and riches are in our houses, and our righteousness endures forever. We are sanctified with long life, and God shows us his salvation. We dwell in the secret place of the Most High, and abide under the shadow of the Almighty. No evil befalls us, nor any plague comes near our dwelling. Our children are taught of the Lord, and great is their peace. We are strengthened with might by his Spirit in our inner man. We are rooted and grounded in love. We bless our natural enemies, and overcome evil with good, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We are called in Christ. We have redemption in Christ. We reign in life by Christ. We are life unto God through Christ. We are joined here with Christ. We are sanctified in Christ. Our body is a member of Christ. We have victory through Christ. We triumph in Christ. We are a new creature in Christ. We are the righteousness of God in Christ. We have liberty in Christ. We are crucified with Christ. We are put on Christ. We are the ear of God through Christ. We have been blessed with spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ. We have been chosen in Christ before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before him in the world. We have obtained an inheritance in Christ. We have been quickened with Christ. We are sitting in heavenly places with Christ. We have been created in Christ unto good work. We have boldness and access in Christ. We rejoice in Christ. We press towards the mark of the high calling of God in Christ. We can do all things to Christ who strengthens us. God supply all our needs to Christ. Christ in us, the hope of glory. We are complete in Christ. We are dead with Christ. We are risen with Christ. Our life is hid in Christ in God. Christ is our life. We have the mind of Christ. We are partakers of Christ. We are preserved in Christ, in the name of Jesus. Father and God, we rise early to declare your lordship. We get under the covering and anointing of the early riser. We come in agreement with the heavens to declare your glory. Lord, release mysteries to us and bring heaven down to earth. The stars are battling on our behalf ahead of time. Our appointed time are set by God in the heaven. We declare spermatic word to make contact with the womb of the morning and make her pregnant. At sunrise, at dawn, she gives birth to the will of God, and light shines on darkness to shake it from the heaven. At twilight, let our enemies flee and newly found spoil await us as our destination. Our destiny is inevitable. Oh God, our prayer meets you this morning. We command the morning to open its ears to us and hear our cry. Conception takes place so that prayer rains down and is dispatched upon the earth to do your will. We command the earth to get in place and receive heavenly instruction on our behalf. Our land is subdued. We command all elements of creation, take heed and obey. As our praise resound and the day breaks, the earth yields an increase to us. We declare the first light has come. The first fruit of our morning is holier and the entire day is holier. We prophesy the will of God to the morning so that the day spring will know its place in our days. We decree that the first light shakes wickedness from the four corners of the earth. The lights are falling unto us in pleasant places in the name of Jesus, and our inheritance is secured. We are strategically lined up with leaders that touches the third heavens and sit on the earth. The angels are descending and ascending according to the word that we speak. Whatever we bind and loose on earth is already bound and loose in heaven. Revelations, healing, deliverance, salvation, peace, joy, relationship, finances, and resources that were demonically blocked are loose to us now in the name of Jesus. What is released to us is transferring to every person that we associate ourselves with in the name of Jesus. We are contagiously blessed in the name of Jesus. As we command the morning and capture the day, time is redeemed in the name of Jesus. The people of God are taking authority over the fourth watch of the day. The spiritual airways and highways have been hijacked for Christ. The atmosphere of airways over us, our families, our church, our community, our city, our state, our nation, and the world is producing new climate. The new climate is constructing godly strongholds in times of trouble. The thinking of people will be conducive to the agenda of the kingdom of heaven. Every demonic agenda and evil thought pattern designed against the agenda of the kingdom of heaven is destroyed at the root of conception in the name of Jesus. We come into agreement with the saint as we have suffered violence. We now take it by force. No longer we will accept anything that is dealt to us in our days. We declare that the kingdom has come and the will of God is done on earth as it is done in heaven. As the sun rises today, it shines favorably upon the people of God, and the purpose of God is established in our life. Daily destiny is our portion because we have no thought for tomorrow. We are riding on the wings of the morning into a new day of victory. God, you separated the night from the day to declare our days, our years, our season. We are the light of the earth and we have been separated from darkness. This light declares our destiny in the name of Jesus. The Lord has given us dominion over the elements and all the works of his hand. He has placed them under our feet because we fear the name of the Lord. For the Son of Righteousness arises with healing in his wing, and we continue to tread down the wicked until they have become ashes under our feet. We commit the work of this dominion daily. We decree and declare a new day, a new season, a fresh anointing. As the ordinances of the constellation have received orders from God on our behalf, they manifest now in the earth realm in the name of Jesus. The ingredients of our destiny are programmed into our days, our years, and our season. We bind every force that will attempt to capture our destiny illegitimately in the name of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus Christ over every principality, every power, every ruler of darkness and spiritual wickedness in high places assigned against our purpose. We bind every destiny pirate, every destiny thief, every destiny devourer in the name of Jesus. They are dethroned and dismantled and have no influence over our days. Every curse sent against our days is reversed and boomeranged back to the pits of hell. We displace the Luciferian spirit in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We bind every false light bearers and counterfeit son of the morning. Our prayer disrupt dark plans and give our enemy a non-prosperous day. We have victory over our enemies every morning because we obey the Lord and serve him. Our days are prosperous, and this is the day that the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we repent of our sins and the sins of our past and of our present that may walk against the lives of our children in a negative fashion. We call out our children by name. We thank you for the salvation, their healing, their deliverance, their prosperity, oh God, and the prosperity of our children. Every hidden and secret enemy operating behind the scenes, sins in their lives is now under the spotlight of the Holy Ghost, uncovered forever. We command every generational sin in our life and the life of our ancestors to disconnect from our heritage and disconnect from their heritage now. In the name of Jesus, we plead the blood of Jesus Christ over every of our children's navel. The blessing now flows to our children and no curses touch them. Every demonic umbilical cord is severed in the name of Jesus. All inheritances that rebelliously flow through our bloodline are cut off from them forever in the name of Jesus. All enemy devourers, all destiny devouring spirit are displaced by the destiny angel of the Lord. We walk in the authority that Jesus Christ has given us over our seed. We break the powers of peer pressure and ungodly associations in the name of Jesus. Our children lead and do not follow. They are not bound and influenced by the spirit of the world. Every vicious circle that is ruling over the head of our children through associations, incantations, generational influences is destroyed by the whirlwind of the Lord. Self-inflicted curses through negative confession are broken in the name of Jesus. All negative words spoken over our children through ignorance or intentions are erased in the name of Jesus. We cause doors that have illegitimately opened and legally made a way for demonic activities to operate in their children's lives. We command such doors to be closed in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. All our seed have been planted in the lives of our children while they were sleeping. We command them to be uprooted. All seed that have been planted, oh God, that are negative, oh God, affecting our children, we command them to be uprooted. The fallow grounds are broken up and the seed of the Lord displaced them. Every entry point through a nightmare or dark vision through astral activity is closed continually in the name of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus Christ over our children as they sleep at night in the name of Jesus. We command sweet sleep and divine rest upon them. Incubus and succubus and other forms of perversion abound in the name of Jesus. We take authority over the terrors that come by night and we declare that the sun rises his shine favors upon our seed. The will of God has captured our children's days. They will fulfill the call of the Lord and they shall be called blessed. Princes, powers and spiritual wickedness in high places have no dominion over our children. The spiritual airways are prosperous over their heads, over the heads of our children, and they live full lives. The statistics of the children of the world do not overcome them because they are the children of light. The countenances of our children shine above the children of the world. They do not eat of the king's portion, but are continually transformed into the image of Jesus Christ. Our children are in the world, but they are not of this world. But the wealth of the wicked is finding its way to them. The hidden are their inheritance. They possess the gates of their enemy, and they displace them in the name of Jesus. The God of the cosmos is bound and cannot prosper against them. Our children can discern the difference between what is holy and what is common. They are not set up or deceived by cosmetic fetish, by people, places, things with demonic that are demonically attached in the name of Jesus. The borders are extended for our children. They rise up and demand room to live. Rebellion, disobedience, and unbelief have no rule over our children, have no rule over our seed. We circumcise our children with a sharp knife of the word of the Lord, and we pull them out of the ways of uncircumcised. Our children are wealthy, our children are wise, our children are in the place to receive from God, that the word that will speak over them, they shall speak over their seed. Our children shall not be prematurely taken out by sickness, by disease, by accident, by incident, or the cares of the world. They will live long, prosperous life to serve God eternally. This is the heritage of our children for a thousand generations. This water forever programs in the heavens in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Mighty God, it is you who gives us the power to get wealth, that your covenant is established in the earth and in our life in the name of Jesus. Lord God Almighty, will break and will disannul all assignments of the enemy against our finances in the name of Jesus. Father, we break and we annul all causes of poverty, lack, debt, and failure in the name of Jesus. We seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all things shall be added unto us. We rebuke and cast out all spirit of the canker worm, of the palmer worm, of the caterpillar, of the locust that will eat up our blessings in the name of Jesus. Lord God, you teach us to profit and you lead us in the way that we should go. You are Jehovah Jireh, our provider. You are El Shaddai, the God who is more than enough. Wealth and riches are in our house because we fear you and delight greatly in your commandment. The blessing of the Lord upon our life make us rich and have no sorrow with it. We are blessed coming in. We are blessed going out. We are blessed in the city and we are blessed everywhere we go. We are God's servants and it takes pleasure in our prosperity because we favor his righteous cause. Jesus Christ, you became poor that through your poverty we might be made rich. We meditate in the word day and night, and that so whatever we do shall prosper in the name of Jesus. Peace is within our walls and prosperity in our palaces in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We prosper through the prophets and prophetic ministry in the name of Jesus. We believe the true prophets of God and we prosper in the name of Jesus. We are your servant, Lord. Thank you for prospering us. The God of heaven prospers us. We live in the prosperity of the King. Through your favor, Lord, we are prosperous people in the name of Jesus. You have called us and you have made our way prosperous daily. We pray and fast in secret and you reward us openly. We are rewarded because we trust you and we diligently seek you. You have released words of the wicked into our hands in the name of Jesus. We thank you, God, that you have brought us into our wealthy place. Lord God, we give and it is given back to us. Good measure, pressed down, shaking together and running over. But the floodgates of heaven are open over our life and we receive more than enough, oh God, that we may not have room enough to contain them in the name of Jesus. We pray, God, that there is no hole in our backs, that the devourer is rebuked and his assignment is cancelled for our sake in the name of Jesus. All nations shall call us blessed and we shall be delightful land in the name of Jesus. We are in league with stones of the field in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Our gates are open so that the wealth of the nation comes into our life continually in the name of Jesus. Your showers of blessing are upon our lives. Our vats overflow continually in the name of Jesus. Our barns are filled with plenty and our presses burst with new wine. You have commanded your blessing upon the storehouses, oh God. Our barns are full and overflowing. Our sheep bring forth 1,000 and 10,000. Our oxen are strong to labor. The plowman overtakes the reaper in our life and the treader the grapes, the sower of the seed, and we live in continual harvest in the name of Jesus. Our floor is full of wheat and our vat overflow with wine and oil in the name of Jesus. You have dealt wondrously with us. We will eat and be satisfied. That you will lead us into a land flowing with milk and honey in the name of Jesus. For you have brought us into a land without scarceness or lack in the name of Jesus. For all grace abounds towards us because we have all sufficiency in all things and abound to every good work. Our head is anointed with oil and our cup runs over. We have riches and honor in abundance. The rock pours a river of oil unto us. Our feet is dipped in oil in the name of Jesus. Oh God, we love wisdom and we inherit substance and our treasures are full at all times in the name of Jesus. You have brought honey out of the rock for us in the name of Jesus. We have plenty of silver in the name of Jesus. Your river of life lead us to gold in the name of Jesus. We inherit the land. We refuse to allow the angels of blessing to depart without blessing us in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Oh God, we cut the bands of the restrainer and we command the world's financial system to give up and release its wealth and resources that rightfully belongs to us and our families In the name of Jesus, we request angelic assistance to ensure the complete success of this confession now, and we release our faith and we call it done in the name of Jesus Christ and by the power of the shed blood. In the name of Jesus, your kingdom come, your will be done in our life as it is done in heaven. Your kingdom advances in our city and is established through preaching, teaching and healing. The gates of our life and the city are now open to the kingdom glory to come in. In the name of Jesus, you reign in our lives, you reign in our city, you reign in our homes, you reign in our ministry. You are clothed with majesty and strength, your throne is established of old, you are from everlasting to everlasting. You are the great king above all, God, the hidden years of the Lord reigns. You reign, the people tremble and the earth move. You have prepared your thrones in the heaven and your kingdom rules over all. In the name of Jesus, bless the Lord in all places of his dominion, the earth and the fullness of it. Your kingdom is an everlasting kingdom and your dominion endures throughout all generations. Men speak of your glory, men speak of the glory of your kingdom and talk of your power. Men know your mighty act and the glorious majesty of your kingdom. Your kingdom comes through deliverance in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The gospel of your kingdom is preached with signs and wonders following in the name of Jesus. Father, we receive the kingdom because it is your good pleasure to give us the kingdom, the righteousness, peace, joy of the kingdom are established in our lives now and forevermore in the name of Jesus. For the kingdom of this world has become the kingdom of our Lord and his Christ in the name of Jesus. For the sin possessed the kingdom of God, we overthrow the thrones of wicked kingdoms in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, for delivering us from every evil work and preserving us for your heavenly kingdom in the name of Jesus. For the scepter of your kingdom is released now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We seek first your kingdom and your righteousness and all other things are added unto us now in the name of Jesus. Lord Jesus, you destroy in pieces and consume every demonic kingdom. Cities resisted your kingdom, cities resisted your dominion, cities resisted your rule at the cross. In your name we exercise the dominion you gave us. Our enemies is defeated now. All dominion serve and obey you now. Oh Lord God, in the name of Jesus, we give you praise, we give you glory, we thank you for your word in heaven is forever settled. We thank you, Abba Father. Be thou exalted, Lord Jesus. Be thou magnified, God. In Jesus' name, amen.